everybody, welcome to an Epic My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be discussing a brand new thing that I want to bring to the channel that actually is going to intertwine with other parts of the channel, and you'll know what I mean here in a few minutes. But first of all, I do want to give a huge shout out to everybody that tuned into the stream yesterday. We went live on YouTube, we played Fortnite for a little bit, then we played some H1Z1. It was really fun. Got to talk with a lot of fans, got to even play with some fans. It was really fun. I had a ton of fun getting on there, talking to you guys, and just kind of hanging out for a little bit. I plan on getting on Twitch and doing the same thing maybe a few times a week, possibly every day. It'll just kind of depend on how the time works out. But if you guys have a Twitch account, definitely go check me out on Twitch. I'll put a link in the description so you guys can go subscribe or follow me on Twitch. But as you guys can see here on the screen today, during our live stream, we talked about something, and I can't remember who brought the idea up, but they said to do a custom series. I don't know if you guys know who BEW is. Some other customizers, some other people in the community do these custom series where I think my boy on Stable 1047 does them. I mean, he like commissions them and he has his own series of figures. BEW does it where he does his own series where he'll customize like six figures in a set and make it like his own BEW custom series. And so I planned on doing my own MDT series, and you guys know that I love white fantasy attires. In the past year on the channel, I have done many white attires, and I planned on doing the Dolph Ziggler white attire, right? So I figured, let's go ahead and make an MDT white series. And so today we're going to be discussing that series and talking about who I plan on putting in the series, showing off the figures that I plan to work on and showcase, you know, what I plan on doing with them and stuff like that. But here you guys can see, I mean, look at all these white figures we have right here. This is some I've made in the past. I've made Finn Balor, Aleister Black, AJ Styles, Roman Reigns. This was commissioned by BEW, but I did commission this white attire Randy Orton. I made this white attire Rey Mysterio. I used to have a Triple H, but I ended up selling it on eBay, and so I actually planned on remaking it because it wasn't the best custom ever. So I actually am going to remake that one possibly for the new series. We'll just have to see about that. I know I can remake it better because I think the last time I made that was like 2017 or something. One thing I'm going to need to make this custom series is this right here. And if you guys are wondering what paint I use, this is the best paint to use right here, guys. Citadel Air White is the best you can use. White Scar. You can get it on Amazon. They've made these new ones that are super tall and nice. They have thinned out white paint, and that's how you get the good layers on there. That's how, you know, you make the figure look really good. That Roman Reigns, it took a lot of white paint. Like, it's not as clean as it should be, but that figure would look a lot worse if I would have used a different white paint. It looks pretty good from here. It is a little bit clumpy, you know, it's not perfect by any means. But, you know, I made the white little decal there. I plan on, when I make the white attire, I'm going to get some decals from Curb Stomp Custom City Decal, or Curb Stomp City Custom Decals. Kind of butchered the name there. But I plan on putting them together with the white attire. So I'm not going to just make it plain white. As you guys can see with Finn Balor, his is plain white, but Aleister Black's isn't plain white. AJ Styles isn't plain white. Roman Reigns isn't. He's got the gold stuff. Randy Orton isn't. Rey Mysterio isn't. So I don't really want to make, you know, the guys just plain white attires, because that would be kind of boring. Even Andrade here has some stuff going on his knee pad. So I want to do where we make the attire and then we put some custom decals with it, or maybe I can paint the logos that are already on the figure. That way we can make it where they have some, you know, they have some designs. They have some other colors mixed in with it, and it's not all white, because an all white attire isn't the best. I mean, the Finn Balor's not bad because it's pretty. It's a plain attire. It kind of looks like a New Japan or indie style attire, which is just plain Jane. But it would look really sick if it had like some gold Balor logos or something like that on it. I think that would be really sick. I think a Demon Finn Balor in full white would be pretty cool. So that's something that we could possibly do as well. And I'm still mulling over, you know, different details of the series, but I think this could also play into our custom championship or custom of the month. You know, when we put all the customs together that we've done for the month, we'll bring in the white series, and maybe one of those white series figures can hold the custom MDT championship that I'm still working on as well. So that could be something that we put together with that. And that would be really, really cool. But anyways, guys, let's dive into the series. Let's dive into the guys that I want to put into the white series. And if you guys have any suggestions for any guys that you would like to see in the custom MDT series, let me know down in the comment section below. And also let me know if you would be interested in some MDT merch, possibly a couple t-shirts and a hoodie. Let me know down in the comment section below. But let's dive into it, guys. The first guy that I had to put in the series, and you guys probably already know who's coming. You guys already know about Dolph Ziggler, but Cedric Alexander had to be in here because I love Cedric Alexander. I think he's fantastic in the ring. Lumbar Voracek's my favorite finisher in all of wrestling. And, I mean, we're kind of halfway there to a white attire. I mean, look at this. I mean, this is pretty much a white attire already, except for the trunks and the armband. So I might go ahead and just paint over these trunks and this armband over here to give us the white attire. And I'll probably switch out this necklace with either a white necklace or a color necklace that goes into the trunks. But I haven't figured out what secondary colors I want to use, but this thing's almost there. I mean, Jesus. And we made this fix up forever ago before I even knew about the white series, so I thought that was pretty cool. But there's Cedric Alexander. I may not use this as the base because I really like this fix up. I may go back to normal with it, but this was such a perfect torso crack for the Cedric Alexander. I really don't want to ruin it, and I want to have a figure that's in this base right here with the Black Panther attire. And I do have like four or five of the Cedrics because I wanted to make customs in the future, but we'll just see about that. But let's move on to our next figure, guys. It is Dolph Ziggler. We already discussed this. How I plan on doing this is I plan on torso swapping the Sting figure right here with this, and then putting the white boots over here. I'll get some knee pads. I'll acetone this Scorpion off, and then we will put all the good parts on it. We'll put the Elite 70 Dolph Ziggler head sculpt on it, which is over here. We'll put this head sculpt on there, this torso, some smaller arms. We'll put the white boots, and then we'll get some decals and some paint going on there, and I think that will be really, really sick. At the end of the video, be sure to let me know which one you guys think will win the, which one will be the best custom out of the white series. But I'll probably start on these today because I don't think I have much to do today. But there's Dolph Ziggler right there. That's my second guy in the series. The third guy in the series, it was kind of hard to work out the kinks. I know these two right here are concrete. I don't know about the rest in the series. The rest are kind of up in the air. They could switch. They could be switched out for some other people. But moving on to the next figure we got is Johnny Gargano. Now, I saw a really cool 2K attire in white on there, and I figured that I would want to make that attire. The only thing is the Johnny Gargano Elite 70 figure is super expensive, man. It's actually a really expensive figure. I think that's because it's Johnny Gargano. You guys know, like, guys like Ciampa, Cole, Ricochet, Gargano, any guys like that, they usually skyrocket in price because they're highly sought after, much like Pete Dunne, guys like that. Anybody that's an NXT guy that we don't get all the time, their figures usually skyrocket in price. Maybe that has to do with more, NXT fans are usually the more hardcore wrestling fans, and so they probably just buy out those figures more than, the Braun Strowmans and all those figures that we get so many of. I feel like I would love to see the overlap of the hardcore wrestling fans and the wrestling figure collectors. I feel like that overlaps a lot, but I don't know. I could be wrong about that, but Johnny Gargano would be a really fire one. You guys know about the Iron Man Johnny Gargano. That would be a really sick one. Next up we have is Jeff Hardy. You guys probably figured Jeff Hardy would be in the set. Now, we did try to make an all-white Jeff Hardy for Hell's Gate, and it freaking fell on its face, man. It fell on its face, and I actually think I could figure out a way to fix it this time, but it would, I do have a way of fixing it. It's just going to depend on a couple of things. I wish this figure would have been released at the time of making that figure, because the only reason it didn't work is because I took a Dean Ambrose torso and tried to put that onto a Jeff Hardy or a Matt Hardy crotch, and it did not work. So, I don't know, man. We'll just have to see how it goes, but I ran into so many issues trying to get that Jeff Hardy figure to work for Hell's Gate, so I had to abandon that last second, and you guys know that the face paint we used was different than what we were going to use, or the face paint was the same, but the body was not the same. I was trying to go with an all-white body, like pants and shirt and long sleeve. It would have been very sick, but it did not work out. But that's the next guy in the series. Jeff Hardy with a sick white face paint or something would be really dope. Next up, guys, is going to be Brock Lesnar. Now, this is somebody that the chat recommended yesterday. They said, give me a white shorts Brock Lesnar, and I was like, you know what, bro? That would be pretty sick. I don't know if I would do the Ultimate Edition. If you guys didn't know, the Ultimate Edition Brock Lesnar is super expensive right now. I think it goes for like $90 or $100, which is ridiculous. If I ever see this at retail, I'll definitely purchase it because I don't want to use an Elite, but, it may be the only way we can do it outside of the Ultimate Edition being that that's so expensive. I'm not trying to spend a fortune on this custom series, especially when I'm not going to be selling the figures after I make them. I'll probably be holding on to them. I might sell them in the future or something, but I typically don't sell figures that I create because I fall in love with the process of making them. Then once they're made, it's like, God, I love this figure. I can't get rid of it. And that's probably one of my biggest problems. You guys see the shelves. But Brock Lesnar would be cool if you had white trunks here with the black Brock Lesnar skulls. And then on the back, this in black on white shorts would look really sick. Maybe some white gloves, maybe some white boots. I don't know. I think that would be really sick. That's something that we could definitely take a check at. All right, guys, moving into the last figures in the set. The second to last one is going to be Adam Cole Bebe, who celebrated his birthday yesterday. Happy late birthday to Adam Cole. He would be really cool. I think that it would be relatively simple. You could put some white wrist tape arms on there, maybe some white boots, maybe some white knee pads. You come in here, just paint over this in white. You can do whatever colorway you wanted. Maybe you could do like gold, black, and silver, or like gold and black for the Undisputed Era. Maybe you could do the same thing back here, just fill in the gold and black, and then paint all the trunks white. Make these little bars right here in a different color, or just paint over them. I don't know. You could probably do like yellow, white, and black. I'm not sure. There's a lot of potential with Adam Cole. It'd be a relatively simple one, but it's something that, you know, would be fun to do. You can make an Undisputed Era one. You can make one for the Pick Fed. Even though, I don't know when the hell we'll see Adam Cole again after that freaking one-winged angel off the top of the pod. But the last figure in the set that I thought about doing, guys, is Undertaker. Now, this one would be a big pain in the arsehole because it is the Undertaker, right? I mean, you'd have to paint the singlet, the belt, the crotch, the gloves, the legs, the boots. It would be very similar to the Roman Reigns back there, where it would just be a full black attire painted in full white. And I probably need to get on Amazon and order me some new Citadel Air White, because this stuff is gonna go fast trying to do all of these white customs. And that is something that I do need to go ahead and prepare for, because that is gonna happen. It's just gonna happen. Undertaker would require a lot of white paint. And so, I don't know. We'll just see about that. It's not about the white paint. You know, I don't really care about ordering more because I love that paint. It'll definitely get usage out of it. But out of all of these figures, guys, who would you like to see in the MDT White Series? I know for a fact I'm doing Cedric and Dolph, and the rest of them are kind of up in the air. I'd be down for all of them, though. You know, I'll eventually probably get to all of them. How sick would it be when the whole, like, maybe we do, like, 30 customs in white? How sick would it be to put them up on the shelf and you could see all the different white attires that all of them are wearing? That would be really cool to see. I feel like white attires, you don't see them a lot, man. You know, we have the Elite 45 Rollins. We have some, you know, we have the White Usos. We have Matt Hardy. We've seen some other guys, you know, Andrade. But you don't get to see white attires very often in WWE. We saw WrestleMania 36 Rollins as well. But it's just not one of those things that happens all the freaking time. But that is going to do it for today's video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Let me know all of the stuff down in the comment section below, what I should put in the White Series. Also, check me out on Twitch. Link in the description below, as well as merch. If you guys want to see some merch, let me know down in the comment section as well. But I'm getting the hell out of here. Thank you so very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.